This is why you should never open your door for strangers. In 2013, a woman let her dog out to use the bathroom one more time before bed. After only a few minutes, she starts hearing scratching on her door, which is typically the sound her dog makes when he's ready to come in, but it just seemed way too soon for him to be done being outside. So she decides to look through the peephole to make sure it really is her dog, but what she sees is terrifying. A deranged-looking man is right outside her door, staring intently at her door handle, waiting for it to turn open. As she's looking in horror, unable to do anything, he starts scratching at the door as hard as he can, never leaving his gaze from the door handle. She manages to stifle a scream, she backs away, and realizes her dog is still outside. So she goes to the side window, but there's no sign of her dog, and so she goes back to the door to see if maybe the man's moved. He hasn't moved, his mouth is open, and he's staring directly at the peephole. Then he turns around and walks away. With the man gone, she discovers her dog unharmed, his leash had just been cut. But that means he had a knife.
This is the most dangerous kid in the entire world. One night in 2015, Rachel and her husband decide to go get pizza, leaving their 3-year-old son and his 19-month-old baby sister at home alone. Soon after these parents of the year left, the 3-year-old decided to take his baby sister and put her in the oven. He then turned it on full blast, but before I tell you what happened, TikTok still might be getting banned, so I'll be moving over to a new app just like TikTok. Links in my bio if you want to come too. By the time the parents got home and called 911, the baby had already passed away from severe burns. The 3-year-old told police that he had turned the oven on and had watched the entire thing go down. There were no charges against the 3-year-old, but the parents were charged with child endangerment and the kid was put into foster care.
The picture behind me might look like a normal photo, but it's actually one of the most sinister, real-life haunted photos in history. Taken by a professional photographer in 1972 as guests arrived for a wedding, everything in this picture looks happy and normal. But if you take a closer look at the man standing in black, you'll see something odd. You can actually see somebody in white crouching behind the man. All 4 of the people in the picture said that there was no one behind them when it was taken. The photographer said the same thing and that it would be impossible for someone to crouch behind them without him seeing them. This is a better picture where you can actually see the guy's legs and then in the top you can see his eyes. The picture was even examined by police photographers, and they confirmed that it was genuine.
I'm placing all these pictures around my house to scare my mom throughout the whole entire day. First off, she always has tea in the morning. Bam. Then she goes to get the milk for the tea. Bam. Then she goes to make breakfast in the microwave. Boom. Then she always grabs a stick of gum before work. Boom. Then she's gonna go and grab her keys for the car. Bam. When she goes to leave for work. Boom. Now this one's the best one. When she goes to back up, she's gonna freak out. Then at night before she goes to bed, there'll be one in her pillow. When she goes to grab the remote, boom. I have a bunch of cameras set up. Stay tuned for the reaction video.
They're not out there anymore. It's fucking 2 a.m. What the hell? What the fuck?
Anyone out here? I swear to God, fucking
we turn the lights and like, I'm the guy.
Just stop. Buddy, come here. Maggie, come here. Maggie.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, that was bad. Steven, it is 1:03 a.m. Please don't do this. This is not the time, sir. Boo. No, nothing. You're scaring me.
If you ever find yourself in this situation, don't do what she did. It all began in 2005 when a group of cave divers wanted to film a documentary in the most dangerous cave in the world. A few hours into their descent, a huge storm erupted, causing the main entrance to the cave to collapse. In order to avoid the huge falling rocks coming from the ceiling, they were forced to swim through an unexplored part of the cave. After diving for over an hour, they came across an island and decided to set up camp until the rescuers could get to them. After 2 days of being trapped in the cave, the cameraman decided to start filming in case they don't make it out of there. At the same time, one of their crew members does something very stupid.
Tunnels, take your pick!
Oh, fuck it!
This is why you always say yes to tandoori chicken. In 2012, a high school tutor and her student stayed up so late one night studying that by the time they were done, the buses had stopped running. Without another way home, the student asked if he could stay the night at her place. Reluctantly, she agreed. When they got back to the apartment, she fell asleep on her bed and he fell asleep on a blanket next to her bed on the ground. A few hours later, she wakes up to the boy standing awkwardly in the middle of the room with a very strange look on his face. She asks him, what's wrong? He looks at her and says, I'm really hungry, let's go get some tandoori chicken. Confused, she says, it's 2 a.m., just get a snack in the cupboard. And he grabs her by the arm and he says, no, we are getting tandoori chicken right now. And he yanks her from the bed. Feeling totally caught off guard by this whole situation, she goes into the hall with the boy, and as soon as the door shuts behind them, she can tell that he is terrified. He looks at her and just says, I'm not actually hungry. When I woke up, there was someone under your bed.
Got me nervous.
See if you can hear anything.
Wow!
Dude, I don't even know what that thing is!
No, we gotta go stop him. Let's go in!
Emma. I'm fine, guys. I don't need your help anymore.
Where's Emma?
I am Emma.
Dude, I hear screaming.
No, we gotta go get her.
Bro, what is this? Ooh!